Si escucho.
Talk about it with Gatica. We are here live and direct. Look at my guy. We got my guy. You gonna introduce yourself to my audience?
What's good, people? It's Demi D, Mr. Everywhere. You never there. Ooh. Repping the Go Get a TV already.
Hey, Mr. Everywhere.
You never there.
Yo, you heard that? The confidence. I love it. Well, thank you so much for coming on my show. I really appreciate you coming to Studio Square Recordings. Shout out to them. You know, this is lovely visuals.
On point.
You've never been here, but this guy is a big deal, okay? This guy's a big deal. I don't know where to start with you. Let's start with, you're a content creator.
Yes.
We're going to start it with content creation. Mm-hmm. I've seen you in a lot of publications. How do you say that the TV that you just shouted out?
The Go Get a TV.
That's what it was. I've seen that. Mm-hmm. Who's next up?
Yes, that is one of the shows. The channel is all hip hop
for
now. So that's one of the shows on there. That's for indie artists on the come up.
Yeah, I like the way that you guys, so you do showcases, or is it like on a weekly, you bring in different artists?
It's really not a showcase. It's more so like a promo.
Okay.
So, you know, I gather up some artists, usually limited to six. They do a little freestyle to showcase they got skill and that, you know, this is what they represent. And I do a speed interview and put their videos in there. So it's kind of like an electronic press kit.
So kind of like what I'm doing here, too. We're very similar. It's fun that I finally get to interview someone who does what I do, because I know all the work that goes on behind the scenes.
I know.
Are you tired?
I'm tired.
Yeah, I'm tired, too. But, hey, it's Saturday today. You know, live and direct, 8 p.m. We're here with full energy. But just to let you guys know, I know it all looks like fun and games on the gram and on all these different platforms. Facts. But there is so much work that goes on behind it.
Yeah.
I'm assuming you have a team behind you who's assisting, or are you like a one man?
I'm one man. I have some people that I could lean on if I really, maybe, you know, get me some other connects or some spots I may need. But for the most part, I'm kind of doing it dolo.
Okay.
That shit is crazy, though.
Yo, he went like this, because that's where the stress is. This is it right
it
here.
Jumped out.
I totally understand that. Yeah. Like, so tell me, when did this start for you? When did you start doing this? Content creation, putting all these things together. I know your YouTube channel is lit too. I seen your Twitter. Yeah, you got a lot of followers.
Yeah, Twitter is my main focus. That's kind of my biggest platform. But YouTube is where I lean at. That's my goal. I'm trying to be a YouTube content creator. But it started with about 2018. You know, I sat in, I want to come up with something. I've seen a lot of people, like you said, a lot of people doing a lot of shit. A lot of people talking like they about the culture and about hip hop. And anyone that knows me knows I live, breathe, and sleep it.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to come up with something that I could contribute that was different, unique, and creative. So I came up with the If You Ask Me Hip Hop Debate Desk in 2018, which is pretty much music from the late 80s to the mid 20s, because my knowledge is vast and my taste is vast. And I bring on different people on the show. It's like pretty much a debate desk. I bring two guests, like other hip hop heads, artists. I've had like lawyers. You know, anyone who wants to come through that loves hip hop. You know, people like yourself that are also creators.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need to come by. Your studio looks dope. Your setup. I like the way, you know, your lineup and how you do things. I think it's very important. You know, I don't like to just interview with anyone. I'm very like, you know, it has to be on brand. It has to be people who are passionate about what they do. It's not just about the followers. You know, like, I like to see people who are putting in that time and that work into their craft. And you clearly, I seen the videos. This guy's no joke. I mean, the YouTube channel alone is, it's a lot to do these things.
Yeah, the YouTube shit is crazy, because it's like, I know, like you said, a lot of other people, they see it one way, but I'm like, damn, I'm not even making a dent with that YouTube shit. But the consistency is there, and people see the product, and I've been able to build around it.
Yeah.
So, but I'm still trying to learn the YouTube shit.
It's one of the tools.
It's just one of the tools. Exactly. Like, see, you get it. You get
like, because Twitter, see, I'm not on Twitter at all. Like, I don't even have, like, I don't even have a profile. So, and I know that Twitter hits home for so many people. It's just, like, a different platform. I think for me, I'm kind of nervous to write. I'm not really a writer. So, I think I would be, like, grammatically silly and stuff. So, I don't want to put myself out there to be wrung out. Because I've seen people, like, they'll repost something from years ago to put somebody and hang them out. And I'm like, yeah, nah. I'd rather just do my silly videos. You know what I mean? Do it for fun and stuff. But still with the hidden message behind it. You know?
You got to do it. Sneak them the medicine.
That's what it... Why are we like that?
I don't know.
Why is it like that?
It's like we're grown kids.
I've noticed that because I'm really big on like analytics, right? Mm-hmm. And like the videos I put, I try to be strategic and be like, okay, at what times we're being posted and when I bring in certain people, who's the following that it mm-hmm. comes with. But I've noticed that when you try to get educational, people just don't want to hear it. They just don't want to hear it. So I guess we got to get like... We'll get the words on like shorts or something.
It's crazy, like,
and then girls will be dancing and put the words on the shorts, and then they'll be like, "Okay, that's how you spell philosophy." Got you, heard you. So,
word. Nah, that's a fact though. That's some real talk though. I don't know.
But I'm really happy that you came. I want to make sure that this audience is tapped in with you. Like, talk about it. What do you have coming up? What do we have to stay in tune with you about?
I mean, the content drops weekly on my YouTube channel. I mean, on Twitter, as you mentioned, I'm very active, so I have something on there every week. I really support the indie community, so I have their videos on there rotating regularly every single day. I have artists on the week on there. On my IG, I do artists of the week, so it's always something flowing. It's all usually hip-hop related, pretty much most of my content. I mean, I might stray with other opinions with other stuff like that too. But on my YouTube channel, like I said, every week there's a new video, new segment, whether it's on the debate show, whether it's the Listen Up, the album release show, the vinyl show I have. So it's just always a lot of content.
So are you a coffee drinker?
No.
So how are you doing all of this?
Yo, honestly, I don't, well, I'll say this. When I first started, the first 2 years, it was strictly the debate desk and running my Twitter page. I was too cute for IG. And okay. So I'm like, man, you know, I did a little posting here and there. But that was where the main focus was at. So last year, maybe a year and a half ago, I started the new shows, the vinyl and the Who's Next Up. And then I really started, people tell me, like, you got to take the IG shit serious.
Yeah, that's so, where people are.
Yeah, so once I really started taking that shit serious, that's when it was like, okay, yeah, now it's tiring. I'm meeting way more people. And the Twitter's still expanding, so I don't know how I'm doing it, honestly. I don't. I'm like...
It's the passion.
It's the passion, and I'm very organized. I'll say that. I'm very organized and strategic. And I just don't have moments where it's like... where it's... how can I describe it?
I know that, like, with me, I need things on a calendar. And then if, like... Like, that's when you can see it. You're weak at a glance. That's what I call it. Because it's like, you get lost with things. And you'll be like, oh, I got 2 hours to kill. But yeah, those 2 hours could be strategically placed with things that are working on in the future. Even if you only do 15 to 20 minutes of it, that's putting you ahead. So, I get organization is a huge part of it. And that's how people can do all these different things. I was going to ask you, though. So, when you say, just because, you know, I'm right now on a Latin station, Latino Mix. So for my audience who doesn't know, like, what would you say is the difference between an indie hip-hop and just a hip-hop artist? Like, can you differentiate that for me? Like,
I mean, it's pretty much if you're doing it all yourself, more or less. Like, I'm an indie, an independent content creator. There are others that have sponsorships. There are others who are well more known, more access to the mainstream.
So indie is short for independent?
Independent, pretty much. Oh, gotcha. Okay. Because there are independent artists that still have some backing, though. So that's still, I guess it's like levels.
Okay.
When I say indie, I mean more or less the guys that are pretty much still doing their own backing, maybe have their own small team,
mm-hmm.
but still are not really in the mainstream as far as even the well-known underground.
Okay.
They're trying to get to that step. So.
I see.
But their brand is there, their consistency is there, and their dedication is there. Awesome. Not guys that are just, you know, fly by night. And,
yeah. It's got to be hard to balance that imagery because as an artist, you have to be like fly. You have to know and be on the latest trends. But like to have the love of the streets and the underground world, it's a respect.
Yeah.
So it's like I can see how that's difficult. But independent artists are where it's at. And I feel like a lot more people are on that independent artist wave now because they see like the labels, they're really just giving you the credit. They're giving you that credit card to be like, hey, we believe in you. We think that you should do this. Here's a credit card. Use ours. But then we're going to own all of it. So I would say a message to anybody who's out there. You don't need a label. You just got to work on your credit. Work on your credit. Get your own credit card. Put it in your own name. Get an LLC. It's the LLC for me. Yeah. But that's really dope. So when does your show air?
Every Sunday I drop a new episode on my YouTube channel, The Go Getter TV. Every Sunday night is a new episode. But like I said, you can tune in on my Twitter page. There's always postings of all my footage of other artists, of other creators as well. Even if you don't like my show or my channel, I support other podcasters, bloggers, battle interviewers, and other people do interviews as well. So
if an artist wanted to come on your show, what would they have to do?
Well, it depends what show we're talking about, though.
Okay, or to get on the platform. Like, what's the workflow?
Well, you definitely have to be consistent and serious. Like, I used to see before, because I've been doing this for a while, and I used to see before when people say serious inquiries only. Mm. And you're like, man, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
But it's like, yeah.
Now you understand. Yeah,
serious inquiries only.
Like this isn't a game.
Yeah, so just people who and visuals. I mean, I know there are a lot of artists that, you know, they have a lot of SoundCloud music. They got Spotify shit, but if you're not doing any visuals,
it's all about the visuals, right?
I can't. Like, you know, I'll support it. Like, I'll post you on maybe my Twitter feed. But to be on any other show I have, you have to have visuals too. And, you know, at least up-to-date stuff, you know, mixtapes, consistent music.
Okay, you heard it. If you want to be on his platform, you just got to be taking it seriously. But this guy's got views. I saw. We got 20,000 here, thousands over here. So I think a big part of the artistry is also investing in your future. It's not just Definitely. Wearing nice big chains and having the big booty bitches in your videos, but you got to set aside a budget for the promotion, for the marketing. Once you drop all those songs, all that production, like, now do something with it. And it's going to, people aren't going to do it for free, you know? Not if their platform is real. If people are doing it for free, you know, it could be for the love. It could be, but, you know, create that little budget. Because that's going to put you on the map.
Yeah, don't expect it. Because when you're working, you're going to get looks. But you shouldn't expect that and always go in with that intent. Like, you're going to get some people who might look you out, maybe give you a discount, whatever the case may be. But like you said, you should be ready, man. Come prepared to...
Yeah, like, I appreciate the reach out from you. Like, I know... I feel like... Who is it that connected us?
I can't even say. I'll be in beast mode now.
Like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'll be searching. I'll be like, okay, they do hip hop.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I do see that you maybe it was Laz, maybe? I don't know. I know Laz.
Okay, yeah.
But you know other people I know as well, too.
Yeah, I see that we have a lot of friends in common. So
I think, oh, you know what it was? No, I know now. I'm going to salute Laz, too. But shout out to my guy, because I actually just spoke to him last week. Warren Wynn.
Oh, yes. I saw him with you. Yes, that is my guy. Yeah, yeah. He did a great interview.
Yeah, he's dope. I'm trying to have him on the Who's Next Up.
Oh, yeah. If he pulls up, I'll pull up. How about that?
It'll be in the Bronx, so, you know.
We'll do a little double team. Why not? We're here. So, all right. Tell them one more time. I want them to follow you on Instagram. I want them to follow you on Twitter. What's the handle?
Sub to the YouTube channel, The Go Getter TV. The Twitter handle is the same, The Go Getter TV. My IG is Demi D-Man, D-E-M-E, D-Man. You already know. Queens in the building, you already know. Salute, bro.
Stand up. So, you already know. Talk about it with Gatica every Saturday, 8 p.m. Thank you so much for coming by.
Thanks for having me. Glad to be here.
You're the bomb. Uh-huh. And check me next week. We'll be here. Se escucha, se escucha.